Hello, how you guys doing? What's going on? Welcome to the Messy Sweet Spot, and we got a lot of mess for you guys today. Today we are talking about Diddy. Girl, have you heard? Have you heard what Diddy is going on? Honey, come here. Come here. He is going around attacking people, Dookie Shoots. Yes, girl. Dawn, she is coming out and she want her money too. She is telling us that Diddy was going in her Dookie Shoots not once but twice. Let me tell you something else. It was another guy came out just yesterday, a grown man, suing Diddy $100 million, and they say he didn't want because Diddy done pinned him down, going all up and down on his Dookie Shoot, bouncing up and down like a goddamn Karen Ring girl. So we gotta talk about all of it. Now before I go on, I just gotta say thank you so much to my party crushers out there. Do you guys like my hair? You guys know I love hair, right? Yeah, so I wore pink for my party crushers because that is you guys' favorite color. You know, I did cover up today since you guys, you know, was like, you know, can you cover up a little bit? This is the only time, baby. It's like, I'm kidding, I don't know what I'm gonna do. But let's get on into it. So TMZ broke the story, and I do have audio. We're going to listen to everything first, and then after we get finished listening, I'm going to call back or replay it, and we're going to listen to it back, and we're just going to really dissect what's really going on. Diddy, he has an issue. It's either one or two things that's going on with this story. Either someone really want Diddy behind bars, because they're saying that Don recently, when Aubrey, you know, came out and she was going against Diddy, she was like, oh no, Diddy is always my homeboy. Diddy is always my road dog. She even confessed. She said, yeah, I knew I sold my soul. She said, I knew I sold my soul to the devil. You know, we all sold our soul to the devil. They know what they was getting into. Yeah, girl. So now she's coming out talking about she want that money too. So it's very interesting. It is very interesting how everything is unfolding. So are you guys ready to hear? She said she got her daddy involved too. But Diddy was like, if you go to the cops and tell what I did to your daughter going up in her duty shoot, I'm going to go up in yours, Negro. And then after that, I'm going to make both of y'all disappear. Yeah, Diddy said he was going to make both of them disappear, honey, and go in both of their dookie shoots. Because it doesn't matter who, male, girl, it, she, it don't matter. He is going around dookie shoots like Pac-Man. Do y'all remember Pac-Man? That is how he is going around. It's strange. And I knew she knew that he was messing around with men. And girl, did you know this too? I didn't know this too recently, honey. But they tell me that Craig Mack, you remember? They said he didn't die from that, you know what, that, I don't want to say it, but you know what I'm talking about. That H to the E-O. Okay, you know. Yeah, they said Diddy didn't gave his ass to it. I'm not saying this because I'm sure not trying to get sued. I don't know how he got it, but they said that Diddy went up in his dookie hole too, honey, okay? And I guess he got the good medication. I don't want to get into it. Because, you know, they said Michael Jackson, what's his name, Magic Johnson, honey? They said he got the cure, honey. You know, he don't got it no more. So maybe Diddy got that shit too. He got the cure too because they, maybe he don't got it no more. I don't know, honey, but ain't it strange? Girl, this is some shit right here. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe to this YouTube channel, The Messy Sweet Spot. Now let's get to what TMZ got to say, honey. Okay, let's hear it.
Diddy is facing yet another lawsuit from a new accuser, a former bandmate who claims the music mogul belittled, terrorized, and sexually abused her while she also witnessed him savagely beat his ex, Cassie. According to the suit obtained by TMZ, Dawn Richards says she got caught in Diddy's web as a participant on his 2004 MTV show Making the Band with the Bad Boy CEO, manipulating her by promising to advance her singing career if she relented to his alleged twisted demands. The former Danity Kane member said during on-set auditions, Diddy called female contestants fat, ugly bitches and who. She said Diddy had particular disdain for her because she was young and excited to work with such a famous person. In 2005, the court docs say Richard saw another of Diddy's former girlfriends, Kim Porter, crying as she left the music studio with her face all banged up. It was then Richard says she realized Diddy was capable of violence and her life could be in danger. A year later, Richard was present when Diddy was first introduced to Cassie, invading her space while transfixed on her in a predatory fashion, according to the docs. In 2009, she says she personally witnessed Diddy high on drugs throw Cassie against the wall, choke her, and drag her up a flight of stairs in his LA home. Richard says Diddy also hurled a scalding pan of eggs at Cassie while yelling, "I've been asking you for my tea. I can't stand you, bitch. You never do it right." On other occasions, Richard says Diddy socked Cassie in the face and wrapped his hands around her throat, attempting to strangle her inside his LA mansion. At some point, Richard says she and others, including her Diddy Dirty Money bandmate, Vita Kalina Harper, showed their support to Cassie and advised her to leave Diddy, who found out about the conversation and threatened, "Y'all bitches don't get in my relationship," adding, "Don't tell my bitch Cassie what she need to be doing. Just make money and shut the F cake up. I end artists, I shelve careers, you could be missing. You bitches wanna die to die today." Meanwhile, Richard says she too became a victim of Diddy's abuse, forcing her to rehearse 48 hours at a time without sleep. As a result, she says she dropped a lot of weight and became dehydrated and fatigued while suffering awful rashes. She says one time Diddy demanded she come to his Miami home where he was only wearing underwear. When she asked him to put on clothes, Diddy refused, screaming, "This is my king house." Diddy's treatment of Richard got worse, she says, between 2009 and 2011. Richard says Diddy once barged into her dressing room while she was naked at his recording studio. She says Diddy inappropriately touched her breasts and butt. Diddy, she says, also locked her in a car with heavily tinted windows for 2 hours as she screamed for help, even calling her dad for help. Richard claims her dad traveled from Baltimore to New York to free his daughter and confront Diddy, threatening to report him to the police. But she says Diddy told her dad, "Think about your daughter and think about your daughter's career. We've reached out to Diddy's reps. So far, no word back."
Ooh, wait, girl. Arr. Did you hear about them rashes? She said she got a whole bunch of rashes from Diddy. I wonder what it is. You think it's, you know what? You know what I mean? I don't want to say it, but I know a lot of stuff that we just heard, she ain't telling everything. You know what I'm saying? I know that for sure. It's a lot more stuff that she's leaving out, you know. But honey, she did give us a good sound bite. So let's replay, and I want to stop and go so we can really dive deep. Because I know sometimes when you just plan it, you may not understand and hear everything, you know. So I want to replay it again. Y'all mind? Make sure you guys like this video. Make sure you guys get the likes up. Come on. Get the likes up, party crashers. You guys know I love you guys so much, right? And you guys love when I do this gossip, girl. All right, so let y'all ready? Let's go. Get them likes up. Is your fingers broke? No, they get the likes up, okay?
Diddy is facing yet another lawsuit from a new accuser, a former bandmate who claims the music mogul belittled, terrorized, and sexually abused her while she also witnessed him savagely beat his ex, Cassie.
What? I told you. So she sat there and she watched that Kane. She watched that Kane. Put pause on Cassie. Now, Don, why you ain't speak up then? You could have stopped all this a long time ago. Okay? Yeah. Yeah, but I guess, you know, she was used to it. Maybe she got a daddy, because I was going to say maybe she ain't had no daddy, but she had a daddy. So I don't understand. It was just the hunger of fame. They want to be famous so bad. They want to be Hollywood so bad. See, they told you about that false idolization. When you guys are out here and you guys are putting Hollywood and money and fame before everybody else, baby, you gonna pay, and it's gonna be a deadly cost. Because look at her now, she has to go before everybody to try to get some money, to try to get some justice. And no matter the money that she get, it would never justify the trauma that she had to endure to try to get in fame. And honey, she ain't even goddamn famous, okay? Nobody talks about her. Nobody talks about her. So this is what she has to deal with, and she will always have that scar. She will always be traumatized for the rest of her life. And Lord knows, like I said, she ain't telling y'all everything. She's only telling us a little bit, but it's a lot more that was going down. All those years, she was buddy-buddy and eating his buttercups. Yeah, she know he was messing around with men. She was cool with that shit. She had to be. Okay? Okay? Let's go.
According to the suit obtained by TMZ, Dawn Richards says she got caught in Diddy's web as a participant on his 2004 MTV show Making the...
She got caught in his web, or did you go flying? I don't know about you got caught. I believe that you went willingly. I believe that you heard all those stories about Diddy. Everybody knew in New York knew about Diddy, girl. Especially when you going, everybody knew about Diddy. Ain't no damn secret. Okay. You wanted to get fame. And he promised you, like the devil. Like the devil. The devil will always use and destroy you. He gonna give you all these promises and all this bull crap and use you up. What they say, chew you up and spit your ass out. That's what he did.
Band with the bad boy CEO manipulating her by promising to advance her singing career if she relented to his alleged twisted demands. The former Danity Kane member said during on-set auditions, Diddy called female contestants fat, ugly bitches, and who? She said Diddy had particular disdain for her because she was young and excited.
All right, so he called them fat bitches and hoes. Well, shit, I mean, that ain't bad. I mean, it's bad, but goddamn it. I'm sure she didn't, they didn't all call each other bitches and hoes and all that shit, you know. Getting in her dookie shoe, that's the kicker right there, and forcing. Did you hear? She said she was in that car hollering for 2 hours straight while he was, hello, in there like Pac-Man. 2 hours straight, she was screaming and kicking and yelling.
To work with such a famous person. In 2005, the court docs say Richard saw another of Diddy's former girlfriends, Kim Porter, crying as she left the music studio with her face all banged up. It was then Richard.
So this is another time where she saw another girl banged up by Diddy and she continued to stay with him. Whew. Well, I hope she get what she want. You know, I guess she want another $100 million too. And they said that guy from yesterday, the only reason why he won because Diddy did not show up to them courts, but they said Diddy is planning on to appeal. So honey, we just have to see, but you know he want that money. He want that money.
It says she realized Diddy was capable of violence and her life could be in danger. A year later, Richard was present when Diddy was first introduced to Cassie, invading her space while transfixed on her in a predatory fashion, according to the docs. In 2009, she says she personally witnessed Diddy high on drugs throw Cassie against the wall.
He on them sugar boogers. Okay. He on them sugar boogers. You know, they say all them Hollywood people and music people, even not Hollywood, because let's just be honest, this stuff is not just Hollywood, it's in the hood. All this drugs, it's in the hood. All this killing, it's in the hood. All this graping and going after this dookie shoe and these men around here like Pac-Man on that ass, it's in the hood, okay? So honey, I tell you, this whole world is messed up. We are truly living in the end of the world. We are living in the times, they say. Let's continue on.
Choke her and drag her up a flight of stairs in his LA home. Richard says Diddy also hurled a scalding pan of eggs at Cassie while yelling,
What? He threw a box, a pan of eggs. And I told you I want my shit done scrambled or easy. What the fuck? Damn, okay. These girls, honey, they put up with all this stuff. And I tell you women all the time, and I don't know why you guys don't listen, I'm gonna tell you again. If a man call you a bitch, you leave. If a man yell at you, you leave. If he cheat on you, you leave. I don't understand why you keep on staying. I don't give a damn if you got 10 kids with him. I don't give a damn if you don't got no job. Self-respect, have morals and high value. Especially if you want a high relationship. If you want a high value relationship, you gotta have a high self-worth of yourself. These relationships with Diddy, they were low value, even though he has a lot of money, but how he treated them with disrespect. He treated them like garbage on the street. So therefore, that is a low value marriage, low value relationship, because they was not married, but there was a relationship. And it goes with your workplace. You don't allow nobody to talk to you or do that to you or treat somebody else like that, and you see that and you stay there. No, you leave. I don't give a damn. I don't care. You don't have the spirit of fear when you know God is the only person that you should be able to fear, honey, okay? And as long as God got your back, who can be against you? I don't give a damn what he says. The devil gonna stay lying. That's what the devil does. Gonna lie, try to make you fearful. Oh, I'm gonna get this, I'm gonna get that. That don't mean nothing when you got God on your side, honey. Yeah, yeah, that don't mean nothing. I ain't worried about that. Hello, and if I go today, I know I went out for the reason, a good reason. And honey, God got me. And all this stuff in the world, it don't mean nothing, no way. You can't take this money with you. You can't take the cars with you. You can't take none of this. All this is materialistic. But what really matters is your insides and your relationship with the one above. And as long as you know you are right with that, honey, Diddy couldn't tell you nothing. Can't tell you nothing. Because he don't move nothing, honey. Okay? But let's continue on.
Been asking you for my tea. I can't stand you, bitch. You never do it right. Mm. On other occasions,
I can't stand you, bitch. You never do it right. Ooh, wait. I would have left out then. I don't give a damn. Diddy could have said, I got this pow pow. I'm going to pow pow your butt. Do it, nigga. I'm sorry. I ain't supposed to say the N word. I said, do it, Kane. And I would have kept walking. He would have pulled me by my hair. I'd be ready for him because I already know his moves. I would have had a slicing, dicing, cut, cut, cut. Honey, I'm breaking out either way. I don't give a, I don't care what he'd say. I'm going to take this. Eat some. Go get a man. Go get a man. Okay, go get a man. Okay. Kane, go get a man. Go get a Pac-Man. Okay, go get some Dookie Ho. You know what I would do? Well, she was already doing it. I go get him some dookie treats, you know? Because didn't they say that Cassie was going on to get these men? Hell yeah. While he was occupied with the dookie treats, honey, I'm out the door. Peace, okay? But you know, people, she was scared. They were scared. So that fear, when I tell you the spirit of fear will keep you in bondage, the spirit of fear is no friend to no one. The spirit of fear will keep you in hell, will keep you in a horrible state of mind. Y'all better get rid of that spirit of fear. Do whatever you gotta do to get rid of that spirit of fear. All right, but let's continue on.
Richard says, Diddy socked Cassie in the face and wrapped his hands around her throat, attempting to strangle her inside his LA mansion. At some point, Richard says she and others, including her Diddy Dirty Money bandmate, Biden Kalina Harper, showed their support to Cassie and advised her to leave Diddy, who found out about the conversation and threatened, y'all bitches don't get in my relationship, adding, don't tell my bitch Cassie what she needs to be doing. Just make money and shut the F cake up. I end artists. I shelve careers. You could be missing.
Bitches. I would have just took that chance. Be like, all right, I'm out of here. Ain't no way I'm gonna work for a man that's hitting on no woman. Ain't no way I'm gonna allow this and I'm gonna continue to work for a person like this. I would have left. I would have left. It's not enough money in the world. It's not enough money in the world. And what am I doing this for? Fame? Fame? Is that what I'm doing this for? I'm doing this for money so I can have a mansion. But look what I did to get it. Look who I worked for to get all these riches and these mansions and all the fame. It's not worth it. No, 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 no. And by me leaving, it would have changed the game. It would have. I believe so. He would have known, Diddy, you know what? People are leaving from my behavior. I got to check myself. I wouldn't just leave. I would have just told. I would have blew the whistle. I would have blew the whistle. Yes, I would have. No way. No way. I don't give a damn. Back in 1990, 1980, I would have blew the whistle. I don't give a damn. He would have, I'm going to take you out. I'm going to do that. I don't give a damn. Okay. Let's go.
I just want to die to die today. Meanwhile, Richard says she too became a victim of Diddy's abuse, forcing her to rehearse 48 hours at a time without sleep. As a result, she says she dropped a lot of weight and became dehydrated and fatigued while suffering awful rashes. She says one time Diddy...
See, them rashes. It's more to them rashes.
Man, and she come to his Miami home where he was only wearing underwear. When she asked him to put on clothes, Diddy refused.
He already knew he was going for that hoe. He said, oh, see, you still around? Yeah, you must want it. And he thinks he wants that. Yeah, that's what these men think. If you don't stand up for yourself and you don't leave, they are automatically going to assume you want it. Yeah, even you may not want it, but your actions is very telling. You say, oh, I can't stand you did that, or I can't believe you'll do that, but you stayed. Well, I stayed because he said he was going to take me out of here. It don't matter. You stayed. So he going to feel, and a lot of people feel, you wanted it because you stayed. That may not be the truth, but all I'm saying is actions speak louder than words, okay? Yeah. So he got in his mind, yeah, this is hard to get. And he loved those challenges. His last like Pac-Man. He don't mind a challenge. It may turn him on. You know he liked to struggle. Yeah, that's why he probably liked getting in Dookie Hall anyway. He liked the struggle. He liked to, you know, take that, take that, take that. Didn't he say it? Take that, take that, take that. He been telling us who he is in his songs all along, girl. Mm-hmm. Let's go.
He was screaming, this is my king house. Diddy's treatment of Richard got worse, she says, between 2009 and 2011. Richard says Diddy once barged into her dressing room while she was naked at his recording studio. Mm. She says Diddy inappropriately touched her breasts and butt. Mm. Diddy, she says, also locked her in a car with heavily tinted windows for 2 hours as she screamed for help, even calling her dad for help. Richard claims her dad traveled from Baltimore to New York to free his daughter and confront Diddy, threatening to report him to the police. But she says Diddy told her dad, think about your daughter and think about your daughter's career. Mm. We've reached out to Diddy's reps.
No, no. Honey, if I was the dad, I would have. When I showed up, the cops was going to show up. When I showed up, the cops were going to show up. If I was her dad, when I showed up, I'm putting pow, 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 pow at your back door. Okay? Because I know I'm dealing with a street thug. Okay? Yeah, I'll be ready. You don't touch my daughter. No, you don't do this to my daughter. Honey, please. I don't give a damn what these kings say. They gonna say any and everything, but honey, you should have a pow-pow like they have a pow-pow too. I get so sick and tired of the spirit of fear. You guys are allowing fear to determine your self-worth. Okay? You can get a pow-pow just like he can. You have a right to bear arms. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my commentary on here. Comment, let me know. Say, you know what, I really enjoyed this commentary. Comment, comment, comment. I want to know what you guys think. I'm going to get on out of here. I love you guys so much. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe to The Messy Sweet Spot. All right? And I'm out. Bye. I'm going to get you right now. Doctor.